last question. Yeah. Okay. Do we go to we and the planet? Very important. Very important. Especially what has been done in the region of killing. Okay. The planet. We as humanity are part of the structure of the planet. We are not guests living here and then living somewhere else. We are a part of us, is part of the structure, the whole web of life of this planet. And the planet has its spheres as we have. And it is very, very important in this time of history, especially in Europe, to understand that. To be able to understand what really happens. For the news at 8 o'clock gives you only a very superficial row of facts of what really happens. Our planet has an outer body, I told you already. Our planet has an emotional sphere, the sphere of passions and emotions, the sphere of animal instinctive behavior, and the sphere of human behavior as animals. Yes? Human instincts you find in that atmosphere of the planet. And you have such an atmosphere as well. Your emotional atmosphere you can discover. When you are afraid or nervous or irritated, then there is an atmosphere within you that is starting to boil. And when you are irritated enough, then you explode. And then you start shouting to other people and bullying and so on. And you also have a mental level, and the planet also has a mental level. And in fact, that is in fact a sphere where we as human beings really live. We do not live in the outer world. Okay, our body is here present. But we live and exchange in the mental atmosphere of our Earth with its own rivers of thoughts, with its own continents of thoughts. And that is something that is perhaps a new idea to you. But it is very important to understand that the planet at least has three levels, and that all imbalance in the planet starts in the mental, the thinking atmosphere of this planet. All thoughts of separateness, of irritation, of seeing someone as an enemy, start in that atmosphere of the Earth and then reflect on the emotional atmosphere and from there on the outer atmosphere. So when you see an outer war in the outer world with bombs, grenades, with all people, refugees and damaged cities and so on in the outer world, it is only a reflection of what happens in the inner world, the mental atmosphere of this Earth. And we as human beings are directly responsible for the quality of that mental atmosphere because we are thinkers. Animals are not thinkers. They function on that emotional level. And we, with each other, with the whole humanity, we form the quality of that mental atmosphere of our planet. And that is very important, because now everyone understands that our thoughts are our responsibility, one-to-one responsibility, and we cannot escape from our responsibility. So every time when we sit before our television and see horrible things happening somewhere, and we start to yell and, oh, this person is so bad and that country is, and so on, we are in fact making the harmony and the balance on the mental atmosphere, we are destroying that. And by doing that, we are adding to all the turbulence and the negative powers that at last will explode in the outer world. So that is the reason why every time that such a horrible disease comes outward as an abscess that streams outward, yes, every time that that happened since 1875, since our organization started, we answered with an initiative to peace. And as the archivist of this organization, I built an overview from 1875 till now of all those initiatives, and they are following the world history exactly. And because that precious line of activities of this organization has to be available for you in this time to help you being inspired in how to find solutions for the horrible things we see on television and in real time, for many of us have friends in Middle Europe and hear one-to-one what happens there. We do not always need journalists. We decided the following things. There is a group in our organization. We came together and we will produce together as a group a special of our magazine Lucifer the Lightbringer. And we will call it a peace special. Exactly the same as 20 years ago and 40 years ago and in the Second World War and the First World War and the German-French wars and so on. We were always active and always exactly at the right time. And we are preparing that for you. And I do hope that you will read and exchange ideas about that initiative and what you find in that Lucifer special. And I hope that there will be an exchange of thought between the writers of the articles and the readers of the articles, because the world deserves that. So, we are, as human beings, responsible for what happens in the mental atmosphere of the Earth. And there, all wars are starting. And there, by the primitive, let us call it primitive, the primitive attitude and mental attitude of human beings, horrible suffering starts elsewhere. And I want to give you one example. And I took Holland. I took the Netherlands, one of the tiniest countries of this globe. And therefore, I used the numbers of our country. Living without killing. What does that do with the planet? Okay, I looked at internet. Holland, the Netherlands have 17.5 million people. And I think California has the same. But it gives an idea. 17.5 million people, inhabitants of the Netherlands, kill annually. 18 million mammals, cattle, pigs, etc. 600 million birds, poultry, chicken, ducks, and so on. 750 million kilos of fish. 750 kilo of fish, million kilo of fish. 5.5 billion kilos of vegetables. And one of the most astonishing, 2.5 million Christmas trees. Senseless violence, only for just 2 weeks of decoration. You see, 18 million animals, 600 million birds, 750 million kilos of fish, 5.5 billion kilos of vegetables, and 2.5 million Christmas trees. Just an example of one of the tiniest countries of this planet. Each living being that has been killed, just before killing, has a reaction. Human beings always have that as well. Animals have that, but plants as well. And that the reaction is instinctive fear of dying. And that is an instinctive reaction. So with at least 7 billion of living beings yearly killed in such a tiny country, means that we have 7 billion sparks of instinctive fear in the emotional sphere of the planet. No one ever realizes that. And those sparks, like the accu of a car, yes, when you put all the electricity in it, at a certain time, there will be a stress. The level of tension grows in that atmosphere. And planetary stress works exactly the same as human stress. If you have enough stress day and night, for whatever reason, then your heart will become ill. Then your stomach will become ill. And other parts of your body will have diseases. The planet as well. The planet has planetary diseases. For 3 years now, we talk about pandemics. But no one realizes it, that it is not because we humans are ill. No, the planet is ill. And therefore, there is a worldwide illness of many human beings, but also many animals. You know about birth disease, birth pest. What is the name of vogel pest? Whatever the name is, everyone...
Bird flu.
Bird flu, yes. And nearly no one knows that at the moment 6 or 7 very important lines of vegetables are attacked by viruses exactly as we humans are attacked. And that is wheat, rice, corn. All are diseased worldwide by a pandemic of viruses attacking those specific vegetables. Banana, citrus, plum. What do we have more? Tomato, cucumber, and beans and potatoes. You see, the whole package of food you normally eat. And all those vegetable lines are attacked by viruses at the moment. So you can say that the planet is ill by planetary stress because of all those killings, given all those impulses of instinctive fear in the emotional sphere of the Earth. And that emotional sphere has a name in Sanskrit. We call it Kama Loka, the sphere of passion, the sphere of desire. And that is exactly where instinct is working. So you see that the planet, when the planet has stress, then the planet becomes ill, and we call it pandemics. But not only pandemics, but the climate changes due to an imbalance in the Earth's magnetic field. When the Earth is ill, then the magnetic field of the Earth is not in balance anymore. And with human beings, it is exactly the same when they are ill. And what is the result of that imbalance of the Earth's magnetic field? First of all, the shifting of sea currents. And we know our warm Gulf Stream. If that is shifting in another direction, we do not have the climate anymore here to grow crops, because we are more dependent on that Gulf Stream than many people realize. And there is a shifting in the jet streams of the Earth, the whole streaming of the air of the planet. And the results are overdrought and over wet weather and floods and so on. So the dry and the wet weather is dependent on what the jet streams do. And then the movement of earth plates is also dependent on the magnetic field of the Earth. And that means earthquakes. That means volcanic eruptions. That means tsunamis and so on. You see all the unbalance of the planet, the climate, whatever, is caused by an overpressure of that emotional field, that kamalokic field. And the third expression is interhuman climate changes. And that means that between humans and groups of humans, there becomes tension, there becomes eruptions, like a volcanic eruption. There are also interhuman eruptions, and we call that wars. And if you see that, I hope that by thinking deeper about this, you can at least see a little bit the connection between our habit of killing other living beings and the fact that somewhere on this earth a war erupts. And the really sad thing about this whole subject is that the people in the Netherlands think of themselves as really peaceful people. They don't kill. They don't have a capital punishment. They are nice to their prisoners and so on. But they do not realize that they kill yearly 7 billion people, 7 billion living beings. And if you ask yourself, what can I do to purify and to balance, rebalance that whole planetary system, is making people aware that without even thinking, they kill because they call it a producing. The 2.5 million Christmas trees, there was a group in Holland said, we mustn't use Christmas trees and then after 2 weeks throw them away. We have to replant them because we cause suffering to those trees. And the people growing those trees protested. They say, okay, you are right, the forest and so on, we have to protect. But these are trees made for production. These are production trees. Why not kill them? Yes, why not sell them on the market? Why not? They are production trees. And that means that people start to become blind for the fact that there are no products. There are brothers, there are living beings, and no one is ever a product for another being. Not even a human being. Think of the slavery time. Not even women. Think of all the marriages in India where women are used as slaves. Not even children who have to work on the land as slaves in some countries. No one owns another living being, not even a cauliflower, not even a fly or a mosquito. No one can own another being. I hope that this gives you at least some food for thought to help this organization to make the realization that you cannot just kill 7 billion living beings just to live in luxury or to trade with other countries and so on, for it remains killing. And it helps to raise the tension in that emotional, comic atmosphere of our planet, which will always burst, which will always lead to wars, to volcanic eruptions, to climate change or whatever. Even more, climate change by this reason than by CO2 or whatever gas we throw in the air. This is the real internal reason why climates are changing. And if you know that, then you can help to change the mentality of humanity at the moment. So, what can we do? What can we really do when we listen to ourselves, to our conscience? We can purify. En de English Dictionary said to sanitize abuses in the outer world. You can work bit by bit by bit. Do it very modestly. Start modestly, but keep on doing it. Also in your own behavior. And decrease the tension in the desire, the emotional atmosphere of the earth. You see now how you can do that. And third, we as thinkers, by thinking thoughts that come from our conscience, can strengthen the mental atmosphere of this earth, and that mental atmosphere in their higher levels are the immune system of this planet. And we have the power, the inner power, to influence for the better all those things. We can do it on the mental, the emotional, and the outer sphere of this earth. So I hope that I gave you enough courage to realize that you are capable to do so much on the world's situation at the moment by working on those three levels and certainly working on that mental level. A question was, what can we do? How can we inspire others? First of all, tell them that they are divine, that they have a cosmic divine source, and that they are God in embryo, in the far future becoming gods. That you and all others have a free will to go inward. You, of course, also have a will to look outward. But you go inward. There is something within you to go to. You are not a one-day fly. And you have your conscience and your intuition and your inspiration to guide you to a situation, a functionality in this world, instead of sitting backwards and saying, I cannot do anything. And many people say that. What can I do for Mid-Europe? What can I do for Ukraine? Only giving money, but that is all. No, you can purify those three spheres of the planet. And I hope that these four lectures will be re-listened to, because I have the habit to throw, in fact, too much information in that simple 1.5 hour. But I hope you listen again and you use it. Please do not blindly follow what you heard, but you use it to test yourself, to see if it's true, to see if you really hear within yourself the right wisdom to be really a beneficial factor in this outer world. Yes, I think sometimes it's a pity, in my opinion, that the four lectures already are closing now. But I hope we keep in conversation with the other speakers as well to understand better and better what is meant. Next week you hear Bauke with his, sorry that I say it, brilliant approach to the DNA. And after that you hear totally new things the next week about the Eddas, the North European mystical source. Please listen to it, for this will be a lecture we never gave before in all those 40 years that we gave lectures. 40? No, it's already 50 years that we give lectures here in the Blavatsky House. And after that, Joop Smits, with his Egyptian approach to exactly what I told you, he teaches you how to read the Egyptian Book of the Dead and find out exactly the ideas you heard this month. Again, you have the opportunity to put your questions for the last time, and if tomorrow you have another question, write it to in our website, and you will have answers after that. Bauke, I understand there are no questions?
No, there are no questions. Only one thing to add is next week it's your studies on this subject. Not yet my lecture, but first your studies. And the week after I will have my lecture. Yeah.
Bauke corrected me. And of course, every lecture has a study afterwards. And also the Edda and so on. If there are no questions, I think we close this cycle of four lectures again with the Gayatri from the Rig Veda. And I read them for you. O thou golden sun of most excellent splendor, illumine our hearts and fill our minds, so that we, recognizing our oneness with the divinity, which is the heart of the universe, may see the pathway before our feet and tread it to those distant goals of perfection, stimulated by thine own radiant light.